an animal welfare advocate with nearly 30 years experience in animal care and control and over 12 years experience managing three of the largest animal shelter systems in the United States, including New York City and Los Angeles. As an experienced shelter manager, I can tell you that an uncompromising ban on cat declawing in the city of Santa Monica will result in more cats abandoned on your streets and more cats relinquished and killed in your shelter. Like the ban proponents that are here this evening, I abhor the practice of declawing, but I abhor the abandoning, relinquishing, and killing of cats even more. And I'm here to tell you that is what a ban will lead to. It's interesting that you are being told that declawing is mutilation by the same people who embrace other forms of mutilation. Some ban proponents approve cutting the tip off the ear of an otherwise healthy feral cat for the convenience of being able to identify that cat in a crowd. Other ban proponents promote invasive surgery for the convenience of reducing dog and cat populations, another form of mutilation in the minds of some. And it's interesting that probably everyone in this room on both sides of this debate will agree that these forms of mutilation are acceptable. Why? Because we know they save lives. In the same way, when a veterinarian performs a declaw surgery as a last resort, she is saving a life. You take that life-saving option away from a cat guardian, and you will force them to relinquish their pets to a shelter, who, at a cost to the city, will try to rehome them, and if they can't, these cats will be killed. Why, then, when we are trying so hard to end the killing in our shelters, would we want to create another reason to kill? In Malibu, Mayor Stern voted against the ban, explaining that he would have taken his cat to the pound if he couldn't declaw, because his wife's health is at serious risk to a cat scratch. Thank God he had that option. Please don't limit the life-saving tools available to licensed veterinarians or second-guess their professional judgment. When performed as a last resort, declawing is a life-saving remedy.
Thank you, sir. We have a bunch of questions. Ms. Davis, Mr. McKeown, were there someone on this side also? Okay. Oh, was that your hand, Mr. Shriver, also?
Yes.
Okay.
The city of West Hollywood's had a ban for several years. Have you studied what's happened there?
It's a difficult model to really study, and it's the only model that's available. In the city of West Hollywood, at the time of the ordinance, it's my understanding that there are only two veterinary practices in existence, and they were not practicing declawing anyway.
But if they're not practicing declawing, you're telling us, the same thing is true here, because we're not banning declawing throughout the region. I mean, people can go to Los Angeles. We wouldn't want them to, right, maybe. But my point is that has anyone tried to study whether or not there were increased cat abandonments within the city of West Hollywood as a result of the declaw statute?
There has been a significant increase in the number of cats being turned into LA Animal Services shelters over the last several years for a variety of reasons, and it's very difficult to pinpoint whether or not that ordinance was a factor, but it could very well have been.
And why do you say that?
Why do I say that we don't know?
Well, no, you say, because you talk about L.A. shelters, and I'm talking about the city of West Hollywood. Is it because, are you saying the shelters around West Hollywood have seen an increase where other shelters haven't? It's my understanding that all the shelters throughout the United States have seen increases over the last few years because of the economy, and families can no longer, to their great regret, support pets because it costs money to keep a pet.
Right.
But so the fact that there's been an increase doesn't tell me anything. I'm looking for something, you know, if there's been a ban in West Hollywood, and I understand it's a small city and they don't have a lot of vets within the city, but is there any evidence?
It's very, because none of the vets in West Hollywood were performing the declawing anyways, people were probably going to whatever providers they were going to all along. But I can tell you that anecdotally, there are no studies on the number of declawed cats that are being relinquished into shelters. Shelters typically don't track that information. But I can tell you that anecdotally, they're very rare. And when a declawed cat does come into the shelter, it's sort of a cause celeb. Oftentimes people will come in asking, do you have declawed cats? So declawed cats get adopted out pretty readily.
And you said you were in charge of three shelters. What three shelters were those?
Maricopa County in Arizona, which is the Phoenix area, New York City, and the city of Los Angeles.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. McKeown. Has questions?
Mr. Boks, you asserted that supporters of this ban on declawing also somehow support other mutilations like ear clipping. I must say I've never heard that, and that further confuses me as to your stand. Are you LA top dog?
Yes.
Okay. I've seen your blog site.
Okay.
LA Talk Dog blog site. And I have here a page from August 13th. The header is, if you're for declawing cats, raise your hand. And on your blog, you put up the Paw Project's own billboard, which shows a human hand with the phalanges cut off, is what we're doing to the cats. Obviously, you supported what they are standing for here tonight. Now tonight, you're saying, don't do it. You confuse me.
No. I told you, my testimony was that I find declawing abhorrent. And I find that particular piece of advertising absolutely brilliant, because it really does inform people what's actually happening. But I do believe that a ban is inappropriate, because it will there are two independent studies that show that people who have their cats declawed, 55% of them, two independent studies found that 55% would dump their cats at a shelter if that option wasn't available to them.
You mentioned, Councilmember Davis, that you served in the city of Los Angeles. I shared with you by email Saturday a document I got off the LA website, which appears to be a motion by Eric Garcetti and at least four other council members calling for a vote of no confidence, saying you failed in your responsibility, asking for your resignation. Did you indeed resign that post?
I resigned voluntarily because I fulfilled the terms of my agreement with the mayor, not because of that motion.
Thank you.
We have a question for Mr. Shriver and then Mr. Bloom.
When you run a shelter, just listening to you, I don't know anything about it. I actually was going to ask you whether you've been to the Santa Monica shelter, but
as recently as yesterday. Yeah.
Oh, okay. Well, maybe I'll come to that. Part of the function of the shelter, I take it, is to get the animals that are in there adopted.
That's
by
correct.
People. Right. So when you run a shelter, you're responsible for that.
Right.
Right. So when you got many animals adopted, I take it, in these enormous cities where you ran shelters.
The three shelters that I ran became the number one adoption centers in the world during my tenure, including Los Angeles.
So amazing. So in the course of getting cats adopted, and I think you alluded to this, but I just want to make sure I understood it correctly, you received many declawed cats in these shelters?
We receive rare.
Rarely you receive.
Rarely we receive a declawed cat. We don't track that information, so I can't quantify that.
But when you said that you found that declawed cats get adopted very quickly, your implication was that because they're declawed, they're quite desirable.
People are looking for declawed cats, that's correct.
So people called the shelters that you ran saying, do you have any declawed cats available for adoption? And if they did, they would come down and get them. Is that correct?
I suspect people may call, but I was referring to people who actually come in to adopt. They well, oftentimes will ask, do you have a declawed cat?
So when you went to the Santa Monica, do you know anything about that? I don't know anything about it. I should know, but I don't. Whether the Santa Monica shelter sees declawed cats or not, or how they handle that? The shelter that the city runs?
Right. The staff that I talked to, again, shelters don't track this information. And so the individual that I talked to did not have that data.
But did they have anecdotal, or was that maybe you wouldn't trust it?
Again,
hard to tell.
Right. The person was just very, very unsure.
And did you ask them about when people bring in clawed cats, whether they track the reason, or do they never track reasons for people?
They don't track the reasons. So Santa Monica has much to be proud of. It's my understanding that you adopt out most of your healthy animals that are relinquished or are brought in over the counter or as strays. So you have a remarkable record here to be proud of.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Bloom. Thank you, and thank you, Mr. Boks. I'm going to call a few names after Ms. Conrad. If you'd like to come forward, that'd be fine. But just want to remind my colleagues, we have a couple other big items tonight, and we're not even through looking at this. We're maybe halfway through the hearing, and we have deliberations, too, which is going to take some time. Well, we don't even have all our attention yet, so maybe I'll hold that comment for a little later. Ms. Conrad, followed by Mr. Galaxy, then followed by